Hello children, I welcome all of you in today's English session. So children, today we are going to see module 4. First is sentence dictation, in which you have to frame 5 sentences, at least 5, on your own and write them here. Now, suffixes. Suffixes are those words that are added at the end of the word. Suffixes are those words or group of letters that are added at the end of the word, like kind, kindness, kindly. Which word looks better? Kindly. So here you have to add kindly, ly, ness, ly. These are the group of letters that are added at the end of the base word. So kind is the base word, and we can use ness or ly at the end, like kind, kindly, soft, softly, neat, neatly, fresh, clever, honest. Now, you have to select suffix ness or ly to make a new word, then adding full or shun as suffixes. Help, helpful, care, careful, reject, rejection, attract, attraction. Now we are going to see pronouns. So children, pronouns are those words or names which are used instead of naming word. So pronoun is a word which is used instead of or in the place of naming word. The old explorers were very brave. They traveled to strange lands. I am an explorer too. My brother also likes discovering new things. Other children find us to be very different. They sometimes make fun of us. I do not listen to them because exploring is my passion. Now children, there are 8 pronouns. I, we, you, you, he, she, it, they. These are subject pronouns or subjective pronouns. Now what are subject pronouns? Subject pronouns are used as a subject of a sentence in place of a noun. Subject pronouns are used in place of noun are subject pronoun. An object pronoun are used to replace the noun that receives the action of the verb. So object pronouns are used to replace the noun that receives the action of the verb. Now children, we have studied subject and object pronouns in grade 2. Subject pronouns are I, we, you, you, he, she, it, they. Object pronouns are me, us, you, you, him, her, it, them. You have to write subject pronouns and object pronouns in this given space. Now we are going to see reflexive pronouns. So what are reflexive pronouns? When the subject and the object refer to the same person or animal, a reflexive pronoun is used. A reflexive pronoun is used to refer the same animal or person. So reflexive pronouns are myself, yourself, himself, herself, itself, ourselves, yourselves, and themselves. These are reflexive pronouns. Now children, here are singular and plural subjective pronouns, objective pronouns, and reflexive pronouns. So singular subject pronouns are I, you, he, she, it, and singular object pronouns are me, you, him, her, it. Singular reflexive pronouns are myself, yourself, himself, herself, itself. These all are one person, so they are singular pronouns. Now let us see plural pronouns. Subjective plural pronouns are we, you, they. These are many people. Us, you, them are plural objective pronouns. Ourselves, yourselves, themselves are reflexive plural pronouns. Now you have to look at the pictures and you have to write reflexive pronoun in the given blank. Gaurav presented Dash with a toy plane. So Gaurav is a boy and Gaurav is replaced with he, but we have to use reflexive pronoun. So reflexive pronoun for he is himself. Gaurav presented himself with a toy plane. I walked home by ourselves, myself, himself. I is replaced with reflexive pronoun myself. I walked home by myself. In this way, read the third sentence and replace it with reflexive pronoun. Now here are pronouns given in the bracket. Us, she, myself, them, herself, they. You have to read the sentence and use a suitable pronoun from the box. Our dog, Minnie, was sleeping. So, she was sleeping. Our dog, your Minnie, is a female. So, female is replaced with she. She was sleeping. My mother sent my brother and me outside. My mother sent us. Here, you are also included. So, my brother and me will be replaced with us. Similarly, find the suitable pronoun for the underlined words. Then, you have to use correct reflexive pronoun in the given sentences. He dressed herself this morning. He is subjective pronoun and herself is for female. So we will be using reflexive pronoun for he. He dressed himself this morning. In this way, we had to cook all by themselves as our parents were out of town. Now read the reflexive pronouns and correct the reflexive pronouns. This is a paragraph. You have to read the paragraph and there are few words which are underlined. You have to replace the words with suitable subject, object or reflexive pronoun. Tejas is painting a picture. Tejas is using paintbrush. Tejas always takes good care of the paintbrush. Tejas is painting a picture. He is using paintbrush. He always takes good care of it. In this way, you have to read the remaining sentences and replace the underlined words with suitable subject, object or reflexive pronouns. Write those sentences here. Next is paragraph writing. Now, you have to write a paragraph about your first day at school after summer vacation. Here are some hints. Write how you prepared yourself for first day. Explain how you felt. Describe the people whom you met. Mention what happened on the first day. You have to write the paragraph on page number 39. Now, complete the dialogue between Karim and Sanjana. Karim says, "Hi Sanjana, how are you?" Sanjana will answer, "Hello Karim, I am fine. How are you?" Karim says, "I am fine as well. What are you doing?" Sanjana, "I am making paper figures. It is dinosaur. You should try it too." Karim, "I would like to learn? Paper figures. Do you know what the art of paper folding is called? Sanjana will say, yes, I know. Art of paper folding is called origami. Or the name of, yes, I know the name of art folding. Art of paper folding. It is called origami. Karim says, great, let us do together. In this way, you will complete this dialogue writing as well as complete module 4 in neat and clean handwriting. Thank you. Bye.